I'm now joined by our special guest, Labour MP Rosie Duffield, who sensationally won the seat of Canterbury at the last election, ending 160 years of disgusting Tory rule. Welcome, Rosie.
Hello.
Lovely to have you on the show. Canterbury's a very nice place, very English, very posh, very upmarket. What are they doing voting in Labour?
I don't know. It was a big shock. So, yeah, they are posh bits. There are lots of posh bits like the cathedral, but there's also bits where people are really struggling. And I think those people have had enough.
You won by a narrow margin, 187 votes, mm-hmm. Is that right? It's not many. You must be very happy that so many students managed to vote twice. Really helped you out.
I've heard that story. Yeah. I think it's a load of old rubbish, to be honest.
Do you? Yeah. Now, so you weren't expecting to win, were you? This was one of those things where the Labour Party say, do us a favour, stand as a candidate in a seat we know we can't win. We'll give you a seat maybe sometime in the future, right?
Not quite. I just thought I'm on the Jo Cox Women in Leadership Scheme and I've been branch chair of the Canterbury Labour Party for a few years and I just thought, I'll give it a go.
So suddenly you put the rest of your life on hold because you hadn't planned for this.
No.
And as of the next day, that's it, you're at Hogwarts.
Yeah, totally.
Having to be an MP.
Yeah.
I mean, I imagine it's a bit of a pain in the arse.
No, it's brilliant. It's great fun. But I had 90 minutes sleep and then I had people saying, the BBC want to talk to you. And I'm like, okay. And then suddenly everyone knows who you are. You're getting selfied everywhere and followed around. And it's very strange. But the Hogwarts part is good. I enjoy that.
So when you went in there, what's it like? They set you up in a little office, you start walking around and suddenly you're seeing all these famous politicians just walking past, you're sitting in the canteen next to you.
Yeah, there is kind of that. When we had the Queen's speech, I was waiting with some of the other MPs and suddenly I realised I was next to Boris Johnson. That was a bit strange. And the Prime Minister kind of walks past you and it's a bit odd, yeah.
I can imagine. Now, just as you're getting used to it and settling in, you've only been in the job 5 minutes, the horrible Daily Mail and other elements, the right wing press have torpedoed you, haven't they?
Yeah, they have.
You've been monstered by the right-wing press.
I've been guidoed already.
You have, yeah. And this is to do with them calling you a hypocrite for criticising grammar schools but sending your own kids to one.
Yeah.
Do you think that's a fair cop?
No, because I didn't ever criticise grammar schools. I'm not going to criticise the school my sons are at. So they made up the fact that I've been vehemently against grammar schools, which I never have. And I deliberately didn't join in our campaign, which is called Education, Not Segregation, because of being called a hypocrite before I was even a candidate. So I'm not vehemently against grammar schools. We've got them in Kent. That's the system where my children were brought up. And I didn't have much of a choice.
So are there any quotes? I mean, they must have something on you, unless they're making the quotes
up. I think they looked at some of the hustings I did where I said it wasn't a very fair system, but that's still the system as a mum that I had to operate within.
Yeah.
That was the best choice for my children. Both of them went to grammars, one stayed and did his A-levels, one didn't like it and has left and gone to a, I think it's called a free school, because we don't have comprehensives.
So they picked on something minute and blown it up. Welcome to politics, I guess, Rosie. No one said it was going to be easy. Yeah.
This is a silly season, isn't it?
So it is a silly season, and they love to look for what they perceive as left-wing hypocrisy.
Yeah.
It's their favourite sport.
Fair enough.
So what do you feel? Do you feel you've learned anything? I mean, you're still in the eye of the storm now, I should say. This has only been going on for the last few hours. You seem to be bearing up very well.
Yeah, I mean, I haven't learned anything new, other than that, you know, everything seems to be fair game. And when I chose my children's school when my son was 11, which was 7 years ago. I had no idea that I'd be standing as a politician. And the last thing on my mind was whether or not it was hypocritical. I was choosing the right thing for him. So you can't really prepare for these things.
No, absolutely. Now, what's your take on this whole Corbyn student debt thing that's been in the news this week? It feels like he might have made a bit of an error.
I think people got the wrong end of the stick slightly, thinking that we would kind of wipe out all existing student debt. I'm not sure how
that
could
suit,
do that.
Didn't that suit you all and suit Jeremy Corbyn that people got the wrong end of the stick? Because he didn't commit either way. There is no quote that where he explicitly says it. It would have suited him that it was assumed by many students, many of them voting for you in Canterbury, that they were going to have their debt wiped out.
No one ever said to me, will you wipe out the debt, or what's happened, why haven't you wiped out the debt? I haven't heard that myself in Canterbury. It would be lovely, wouldn't it, if we could just get rid of those £40,000-£50,000 worth of debt that people have sort of racked up. But no, we can't, I'm afraid. We can't afford it, I don't think.
You were brazenly ousted a dedicated public servant from his safe seat in Canterbury. So let's see if you have what it takes to fill his boots as we play a little game.
All right, Rosie Duffield, MP, MP this!
Now, I'm going to give you some typical MP scenarios that you may well face in your career. And all you have to do is tell me what you Rosie Duffield MP would do in these situations. Okay. So this is a very much, it's a bit of fun, but it will actually be very helpful. Okay. Here are the scenarios. Now, the government cuts funding to the Scout Hut in your constituency. Mm-hmm. The only way you can save it is by shutting down the old People's Daycare Centre. Rosie Duffield MP that.
Oh no, that's awful. I can't do that. I'm not shutting down daycare to old people. I'd do a fundraiser and get money ourselves for the Scout Hut and the daycare centre.
We said the only way you could do it. And it's a Sophie's Choice scenario.
No, that's just really evil.
OK, well, you're ducking the question, which shows that you are a better MP than we might have imagined.
I'd invite them to both join together and have a kind of joint place to be. Maybe I could do that.
You've been arrested on Clapham Common late at night in an area notorious for dogging and casual sex.
Brilliant.
You need to explain what's going on or your partner's going to hit the roof. Rosie Duffield, MP that.
OK, my son is actually watching this in the other room, but I think I would have to employ a very good PR company or something like that and get out of it, but that will never happen, so...
A new book details something scandalous you did with a dead animal while at university. It was all harmless fun at the time, and besides, it was the only way you could get into that society.
Right.
But how do you excuse this once it comes to light? MP that.
That would be very, very difficult, actually. I'm not sure I could, because I love animals. Mm. And I don't think I'd ever want to harm one. So, no, I can't.
Well, David
MP that.
Cameron obviously loved animals too, but to
greater
degree.
I know, but I don't eat
degree.
Pigs, let alone do what he did. So, no, I couldn't do that.
Sorry. All right. Rosie, thank you so much for coming on the show and best of luck in your new career. Thank you. And also, I'd like to say just before we go, actually, this is episode 91 of News Thing, and we finally had the results in from our focus group. They show it's pretty much considered to be a perfect programme in every way, but the show could only possibly be improved by introducing a competitive element and assigning points to our panellists and also to me. So this is a bit of fun, and we can do it first time. The results are in, and I can tell you Josie Gibson, David Mills and Felicity Ward, and even you, Rosie Duffield, sorry about this. You all scored a disappointing 0 out of 10 this week. But I, Britain's best journalist, Sam Lane, scored a very credible 9 3/4. So well done, me. Hard lines, the rest of you. Better luck next time. Interesting results there. Now, I'm away next week. So next week's News Thing is going to be presented by special guest host Anne Widdecombe. And that's actually true. It's not even a joke. Goodbye.